Here we go. Okay, maybe I should just stick with baking with these lemons. Today we are going to be making lemon curd, and I absolutely love this lemon curd because you actually make it in the microwave, which makes it so incredibly easy. Now this lemon curd here is really good as a filling inside a cake or even like topping a cheesecake or waffles or eating out of the fridge with a spoon. It's really delicious, and best of all, it only takes a couple of ingredients and it's super simple. So welcome to Sweetwater Cakes. I'm Michelle, and I've been teaching cake decorating classes for over 10 years. And I've made a lot of lemon curd, but just recently in the microwave, and you're gonna love this. Okay, so the first thing I'm going to do is I have here half a cup or one stick of melted butter, and I'm going to add to that 3 eggs. Now I wanna add the entire egg, so the egg yolk and the egg white. Most lemon curds just have the egg yolks, but not with this recipe. And now I'm going to take a cup of sugar. I'm gonna mix this up here just a little bit with my whisk. Okay, now before I start juicing my lemons, I'm going to get a little bit of my lemon rind. So I like to use about 1 lemon worth of rind, and it's going to be really important that you don't get to the white part when you're zesting your lemons. The white part is actually called the pith, and it can be a little bit bitter. So just stick with the nice yellow part here of your lemon. Now if you like a little extra zing to your lemon curd, you can definitely add more zest if you'd like. We're gonna save this zest here and use it at the end. Okay, now I'm going to just roll the lemons on the table, and that's basically breaking up the little membranes, which makes the juicing a little bit faster. So I'm going to just use my little lemon juicer. Yours might look a little bit different. I want to get a total of a cup of lemon juice, and that's going to be about 4 to 5 lemons, just depending upon the size of the lemons that you have. See, in this one here, I forgot to roll, and it's a little bit more challenging. Did you know that lemon rinds do a really good job of cleaning out your garbage disposal? Basically, just stick a couple of these lemon rinds in the garbage disposal, turn the garbage disposal on with some water, it'll clean them right up. Okay, so I'm going to add my cup of lemon juice to the rest of my mixture and use my whisk to really just mix it well. I have a couple of seeds in here, but that's not actually gonna matter at this point. Okay, so now in 1 minute intervals, I'm going to put my lemon curd in the microwave. So I'm gonna put it in for a minute, mix it up a little bit, put it in for another minute, and mix it up a little bit. And it takes about 5 minutes total. So I'll see you in 5. So my microwave took about 5 minutes for this lemon curd to be done. And the last time it was kind of puffing up or fluffing up a little bit. But it really just depends upon your microwave, the wattage it has, and that sort of thing. But one way to tell if it's done is just sort of looking at the consistency. It's so much thicker than it was. And also, if you take your spatula, you can run your finger, and if it leaves a nice line, then that means that it's done. Now, remember how I left some of those little seeds in there? It's time to put it through a little strainer. And the reason is not just because of the seeds, but also because of the egg whites and egg yolks. They may have cooked a little bit and they may be a little bit chunky. And we want our lemon curd to be nice and smooth. So I always like to put it through a little strainer here. It streams through very, very quick. Yeah, I can even see that I have a few little pieces of egg in here that I definitely don't want in the final product. Now I'm going to add up my little reserved lemon peel to give it that extra little zing. Stir that up. My lemon curd here looks absolutely delicious and it smells divine. The last thing I have to do is just pop it in the fridge so that it gets a chance to cool down completely, which will also help sort of thicken it up a little bit. And then I can add it to my delicious cheesecake, cake, or whatever. I'm giving this lemon curd to my friend as a gift. And so I'm going to put it in a nice jar just so that it looks a little bit prettier. And my honey will be excited because there is a little bit left over. Thank you so much for watching. Definitely leave a comment down below and tell me, what is your favorite cake filling? Are you a lemon curd fan or are you maybe a raspberry puree fan? Comment down below and tell me what your favorite cake filling is. And of course, you have a beautiful day and go sweeten the world.